Hello, my name is Sandra Shalhoub. Welcome to my channel. Today I wanted to talk about self-exploration as a lightworker or starseed. And I wanted to also share something that I learned about myself and it just to let others know about the what is possible for us to learn about ourselves still while we are here incarnate. I've been following this woman. Her name is Jabine. She channels Archangel Raphael. And she often does free transmissions and clearings and activations with him. And I did a private session with them. And I learned some things about myself. And I'm putting it out there because I'm interested in calling my soul family, my earth soul family, to me. But anyway, I wanted to share a couple things. I've been seeing videos on YouTube about Blu-ray souls, and the description of Blu-ray souls has really resonated with me. And I think a lot of people, maybe even in my age range, are just maybe coming to remember, or recognize themselves as a Blu-ray soul if they're on YouTube and they're watching any of these videos. It's really resonated with me. And I asked Archangel Raphael about it. And this is what he shared. He's basically said, you are part of the Blu-ray. You are not in a frequency of challenging things. But you are bringing in something new. Blu-ray people are about bringing in higher vibe, excuse me, a higher vision, something higher, but in a gentle way. They're gentle people who have a lot to give. They aren't the ones to break down the old systems. They aren't the ones. I'm having to look at my notes because I want to read exactly what he said. They like to bring in new positive energy. They can get on well with many types of people. You are of this frequency. You are one of the people here to make ch changes for others. And then I asked him about the 144,000, and I don't know if you've seen those videos, and sometimes they're referred to as the chosen one. You'll see these videos for the chosen ones. And he said, this is the number. Now, this was in the Bible referenced, the 144,000 and the reference to chosen ones. But anyway, he said, this is the number of people needed to change the frequency on the planet. There are many people who fit in with this, who can be part of this number, but it depends on their choices when they are incarnate. There are many more than 144,000 lightworkers on Earth, but 144,000 is the number of awakened lightworkers needed to change the frequency of the planet permanently. So there, I thought that might be helpful and useful for people who are wondering about it. And he said that I have had, and then, we talked about lifetimes and stuff like that. He said, I had many lives in many places. He said that I'm from a place like the Pleiades where I was doing my own thing, but collaborating with others. It has a frequency where people are good at being in their own energy, independent, and finding themselves and naturally harmonizing with others. You have often incarnated in places with a similar vibration where there is a lot of light and collaboration between people because there is much harmony. You don't understand people on Earth and the disharmony, which is why you have had some blind spots in your awareness. So I thought I would share that in case you can relate to that. And I have done some channeling and I asked him about it. And he said, you're channeling for you. Channeling for me is about being in my higher self, connection, and then allowing other light beings that want to come in. He said it's your way of gaining information on things that you're interested in. It is part of what you are here to do. It will help you to clear your own energy by receiving these transmissions. It will also help other people to understand things better. And he said that he saw that I would be able to channel different beings at different times. And the role of this is to help myself on a personal level and also to help other people. He also said that that I'm very connected to Mother Mary, which I have had some wonderful experiences with Mother Mary in this lifetime. So, he said that he saw that my energy was very influenced by hers. So anyway, I just wanted to, I'm going to call this video self-exploration for light workers. I think many of us are, as we've been shedding layers of the programming, and releasing relationships that are dishonoring to ourselves. It opens up, it's like we're going through a rebirth. It's almost like we've got a new chapter. We're opening a new chapter now, and I particularly with the spring and I think what's going on astrologically. And anyway, I feel like there's so much to explore in terms of our own divine nature and own spiritual side of things. And so I have created what I'm calling the Conscious Creator Circle, and it's for light workers who want to get together, because I think a lot of us feel that we don't have that many people that we can talk to about our experiences and what we're, our own self-exploration. And it helps to have a positive mirror sometimes as we're working through our soul plan and soul mission, and being inspired by others that are also on the path. And so, if you're interested in that, I'll leave details in the description or a link in the description. The next one will be April 11th, and this is 2024. Anyway, I just think this is a really interesting time. I think a lot of us are waking up to our role here to anchor divine light on the planet in our own unique way, that we signed up to do. And so, for me, it's an interesting and exciting time. And it's also humbling, because it's when you start to realize the vastness of being a multidimensional light being and being of source energy. It's no joke. I mean, I like to be like hearted about it, but it's our time. And if you've been a black sheep in your family or in your world, and it's so interesting to me that the black sheep are now the wayshowers actually into the new earth, based on our understanding of our interconnectedness to all, harmony, love, unity, and also celebrating our uniqueness. So anyway, I just wanted to share this. I'm a little bit rambling, sorry about that, but I wanted to speak from the heart and not really be too scripted. But I also wanted to share information that I think my peeps or my soul family might find interesting. So anyway, blessings and much love to you. Until next time. Thanks. Thanks for being here.